Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Surabhi Sharma. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Thursday, the 9th of April. PM Modi says India will do everything possible to help humanity's fight against COVID-19. Afghan government releases 100 Taliban prisoners. And visa service suspension extended till April 15th in Nepal. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Thursday said that India will do everything possible to help humanity's fight against COVID-19. This came in response to US President Donald Trump, who thanked India for the decision to allow the export of an anti-malaria drug seen as possible cure for COVID-19.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Thursday said on Twitter that India will do everything possible to help the humanity's fight against COVID-19. This came in response to US President Donald Trump, who thanked India for the decision to allow the export of anti-malarial drug hydroxychloroquine. Modi said, "Times like these bring friends closer and India-US partnership is stronger than ever." India, the largest producer of hydroxychloroquine seen as a possible cure for COVID-19, agreed to lift the ban on the medicine's export to the US after Trump spoke to Modi on phone last week. Meanwhile, Indian capital New Delhi and nearby industrial city of Noida went through sanitization drives on Thursday in specific areas which have been declared coronavirus hotspots and sealed to curb further spread of the deadly virus.
ये जब से कोरोना वायरस के चले हैं ना सिस्टम कूड़ा लेने का जो घर में लोग बिठा रखे जिनको बाहर निकलना मना है तब से ये गाड़ियां दी गई है ये किट दी गई है तो उनका कूड़ा लेने के लिए किट विट पहन के हम जाते हैं ये गाड़ियां भी तभी से मिली है नहीं
As many as 20 hotspots have been sealed in New Delhi and 22 in Noida. Residents were seen getting essential items through the gap between gates as they were not allowed to step out from some sealed residential societies. India reported 5,095 active cases of coronavirus and 166 deaths till Thursday afternoon.
In news from Afghanistan, the Afghan government freed 100 Taliban prisoners on Wednesday as a first step in a peace process, despite the group's suspension of negotiations on planned prisoner exchange ahead of formal talks.
The Afghan government freed 100 Taliban prisoners on Wednesday as a first step in a peace process with the hardline Islamists, despite the group's suspension of talks on a planned prisoner exchange, crucial to moving to formal talks to end years of war. Javed Faisal, a spokesman for the Afghan National Security Council, in a series of tweets said, "The Taliban prisoners were released based on their health condition, age, and length of remaining sentence." He informed that the Afghan government remains open to continuing joint technical work with the Taliban in order to advance the peace process. Differences over the prisoner release question had been complicating US brokered attempts to create a lasting peace agreement to end more than 18 years of conflict in Afghanistan. A freed Taliban prisoner said he wishes to see peace and stability now and not war and conflicts. The Taliban had earlier this week accused Washington of failing to comply with the terms of the US-Taliban agreement signed in Doha in late February, which includes release of 5,000 Taliban prisoners and withdrawal of foreign forces. The prisoner release is a step intended to be a confidence-building measure to pave the way for intra-Afghan talks.
The United States on Wednesday expressed concern about the safety of the Sikh community in Afghanistan and said that Afghans must come together now to ensure the security of religious minorities. This comes in the wake of the terror attack on a Sikh place of worship in capital Kabul on March 25th, in which At least 25 people were killed.
Top U.S. diplomat for South Asia, Alice Wells, on Wednesday expressed concern about the safety of the Sikh community in Afghanistan and said that Afghans must come together now to ensure the security of religious minorities. Taking to Twitter, Wells said, "I remain deeply concerned about the safety of the Sikh community in Afghanistan. Afghan Sikhs have long been an integral part of the multicultural tapestry of Afghanistan, and Afghans must come together now to ensure the security of religious minorities." The remarks comes in the wake of the terror attack on a 400-year-old Gurudwara, a Sikh place of worship in capital Kabul on March 25th, in which at least 25 people were killed and several others wounded. The Islamic State militant group claimed responsibility for the attack in a statement. Sikhs have been the target of attacks by Islamist militants before in South Asia. Their community in Afghanistan numbers fewer than 300 families.
Moving on, doctors and locals in Pakistan-administered Kashmir have expressed concerns over shortage of surgical masks, testing kits and protective health care amid fears of coronavirus spread in the illegally occupied region.
Doctors and locals in illegally occupied region of Pakistan-administered Kashmir have expressed concern over shortage of surgical masks, testing kits and protective health care amid fears of coronavirus spread. Doctors in the region recently held a protest to highlight the issue, exposing the weak state of the public health system in Pakistan-administered Kashmir ahead of an anticipated surge in COVID-19 cases.
और पेशेंट ज्यादातर जो है ना इस वक्त सफर करके जो पाकिस्तान से आ रहे हैं उसकी वजह से हमें अपनी सेफ्टी करनी लाजमी है।
मेडिकल स्टोर ओनर्स ब्लेम रैम्पेंट ब्लैक मार्केटिंग फॉर द शॉर्टेज ऑफ मास्क एंड सर्ज इन देयर कॉस्ट।
क्योंकि दूसरा मास्क ना तो मिल रहा है जो सर्जिकल मास्क है और ना ही वो मार्केट से अगर मिलता है तो वो ब्लैक में मिल रहा है बहुत ज्यादा कीमत जो पहले जो पीस 6 रुपए का था वो अभी
Locals have expressed fears that the dilapidated and overburdened public health system in the illegally occupied region is not well equipped to deal with the situation, and Pakistan has continued to neglect even their basic demands.
Sri Lanka on Thursday reported a total of 139 active cases of COVID-19 with 7 deaths. Sri Lanka is on a nationwide curfew till April 14th as an effort to check the spread of coronavirus.
A total of 189 cases have been confirmed positive for COVID-19, while 139 are active cases currently receiving treatment at hospitals in Sri Lanka. So far, 7 deaths have been reported and 44 patients have recovered and been discharged from the hospitals. Sri Lanka's Director General of Health Services, Dr. Anil Jasinghe, confirmed that a 7th patient died in the island nation on Wednesday due to coronavirus infection. Meanwhile, Sri Lanka Navy has developed a remote-controlled smart appliance called MediMate in a bid to treat and test COVID-19 patients from a safe distance. The smart appliance developed by Navy's Research and Development Unit, based on a basic concept proposed by Tusara Kelamvadasinghe, an inventor, will allow healthcare workers to remain at a safe distance from the highly infectious patients. Sri Lanka is on a nationwide curfew till April 14 as an effort to check the spread of coronavirus.
Nepal has extended suspension of visa services till April 15th in wake of government's decision to extend nationwide lockdown to prevent coronavirus from spreading. Suspension of international flights till April 30th was also extended earlier.
Nepal's Department of Immigration has extended suspension of visa services till April 15th as per government's decision to extend lockdown to prevent coronavirus from spreading. Department of Immigration's Information Officer Ram Chandra Tiwari said the visa services suspension period has also been extended. Foreigners possessing a valid visa till March 21st and returning back to their countries within the lockdown period or within 7 days after the regular service resumes are exempted from visa fee, late fee or penalties. Those whose visa had expired before March 21st are subject to the usual late fees and penalties. Nepal had earlier extended the suspension of international flights till April 30 to contain the spread of the coronavirus pandemic. However, the government is undecided over whether to resume the domestic flights. The Himalayan nation has confirmed 9 coronavirus cases, out of which one has recovered.
Authorities in India's southern Kerala province have installed sample collection cabins for coronavirus testing as part of a massive testing campaign. People can submit their swabs for the test at the kiosks, curtailing the long procedure to a few minutes.
Authorities in Ernakulam district of India's southern Kerala province have adopted South Korean model of fast sample collection for the COVID-19 test, curtailing the long procedure to a few minutes. The sample collection cabins called walk-in sample kiosks or WISC have been installed at a government medical institute where people can submit their swabs for the test, thus plummeting the 8-step sample collection time to 2 minutes. The cabins are sealed with glass and its interiors are sterilized. The medical staff inside the cabin collects the samples of people standing outside the WISC through a safety hand glove affixed on it, which is sanitized after each collection.
So mainly, our uddesham idu etto pettanu mass screening cheyan venditanu. So in a way, we'll be saving on PPE kits, mathe maximum tests koru samayil cheyanana idu uddeshikkunnathu.
South Korea's massive testing campaign backed by intensive contact tracing has been credited for slowing coronavirus spread in the country. India has so far reported over 5,000 cases of coronavirus and over 140 deaths.
A car maker in southern India has designed a car that is shaped like the microscopic image of the coronavirus to raise awareness and encourage people to stay indoors.
A car maker in southern India's Hyderabad city has designed a car shaped like the microscopic image of the coronavirus to inform people about the dangers of the fast-spreading virus and appeal them to stay indoors. Proprietor of Sudha Cars and the brains behind the coronavirus-themed car, K. Sudhakar, unveiled his invention on Wednesday. Sudhakar said the company plans to take the car out on the streets of Hyderabad after seeking permission from the authorities, as India is currently observing a 21-day lockdown to battle the coronavirus spread.
I thought I'll make something like a coronavirus and show to the people that the dangers of the coronavirus and stay inside, be safe. This is a complete car with suspension, steering, and it has 6 wheels. It can go up to 40 kilometers speed. We are going to take it around the city and get awareness of the danger of coronavirus and stay indoors.
India has reported over 5,090 active cases of coronavirus and 166 deaths, according to Health Ministry figures. Meanwhile, amid the nationwide coronavirus lockdown, animals in many parts of the country have taken over the streets. Recently, a herd of elephants were seen taking a stroll in India's southern Kodagu district as people stayed off roads and remained indoors. The elephants, along with calves, walked freely on empty roads as officials recorded their movement on their phones.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. PM Modi says India will do everything possible to help humanity's fight against COVID-19. Afghan government releases 100 Taliban prisoners. And visa service suspension extended till April 15th in Nepal. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsiaNewsline. and follow us on Twitter at @SAsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.